everyone, I welcome you all, and today topic of discussion is hiatal hernia. So hiatal hernia is the protrusion of the stomach upward into the mediastinal cavity through the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm. Normally the portion of the esophagus and the stomach are situated in the abdominal cavity, but in case of hiatal hernia, there the protrusion of the stomach occurs in upward direction into the mediastinal cavity through the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm. Classification. This condition is classified into four categories. First is sliding hernia, second is rolling hiatus hernia, third is combination of one and second, and fourth is combination of second and third, collectively known as paraesophageal hernia. You can go through the diagrams of types. Sliding hiatus hernia is the most common. Here the herniation of both the stomach and the gastroesophageal junction occurs into the thorax. In case of paraesophageal hiatus hernia, the herniation of all or part of stomach occurs through the esophageal hiatus into the thorax with an undisplaced gastroesophageal junction. It is least common. Here are the pictures of sliding hiatus hernia and paraesophageal hiatus hernia. Now the clinical features. The symptoms most commonly encountered are chest pain, epigastric pain, dysphagia, postprandial fullness, heartburn, acidity, regurgitation of the food, vomitings, weight loss, anemia, malnutrition, and other respiratory symptoms. Risk factors are increased age. So that causes muscular degeneration, and that leads to the weakening of hiatus. Increased intra-abdominal pressure, like in case of obesity, pregnancy, coughing, and heavy weight lifting, also cause weakening of hiatus. Smoking is a risk factor. The most common complication is GRD. Other complications could be due to reflux, dysphagia, heartburn, acidity, peptic stricture, Barrett esophagus, and esophageal carcinoma. Extra esophageal complications could be pneumonitis, pneumonia, asthma, cough, and laryngitis due to the pressure and compression over the lungs. Investigations recommended are chest x-ray, barium swallow, endoscopy, esophageal manometry, 24 to 48 hour esophageal pH monitoring. Gastroscopy with biopsy is done to rule out the cancer. Now the treatment of sliding hiatal hernia. First, the patient is recommended to quit the smoking, to reduce the weight, elevate head of bed, and smaller and more frequent meals are recommended. Avoid too much spicy food. Alcohol and coffee. Medical treatment includes antacids, H2 receptor antagonist, proton pump inhibitors like omeprazole, prokinetic agents like metoclopramide. Surgery include fundoplication. It is a laparoscopic procedure in which the fundus of the stomach is wrapped around lower end of esophagus. There are types of fundoplication: Nissan, Balsay, Dorr, Lane, and Topet. These are the diagrams given.